So technologies that impact jobs are things like automation, robotics, artificial intelligence, and machine learning.
Our history is we help build the internet, so we'll connect people. So if you think about, you know, being on the phone today, being able to look at any kind of news information or shop on Amazon or download movies or play music, you know, Spotify, Instagram, all those kinds of things, all of that is jobs of people who've developed that content, who share that content. A lot of that's because of the work that our company has done building the internet, which is kind of the foundation of how you get connected to stuff. General sense, you know, some of the traditional jobs of people doing some low-level kind of things are going away. I think in the future, it's just going to be more of that. So people talk about the digital revolution, which is going to everything being online and accessible, which means you need more computer systems, more network, more bandwidth, and that's what we do.
A lot of the more technical type of positions are increasing. There's more opportunities there because, like I said, technology is being utilized across all the industries in everything that they do, so we need more of it. If you need more technology, a lot of times you need more people leveraging and taking care of that technology at the same time.
The opportunity to impact jobs with technology are really twofold. The first is there's no denying that technology is impacting jobs. Some jobs go away when a technology is introduced. But really, it's not jobs going away, it's job evolution.
People are being reskilled into more programmatic kind of capabilities, more capabilities around software, and those kinds of things. So there's a shift, but it's also an expansion as more content goes online and more people are, you know, around the world are doing things online.
See, we're seeing specialists who focus on industry solutions. For example, we work with companies in oil and gas industry who make something. And these devices traditionally have been distributed around the world and aren't managed. What companies are looking to do is connect those to the internet so they can monitor them and then analyze the data that comes from them to be more proactive in how they troubleshoot potential failure scenarios. The companies are looking to create these devices and connect them to the internet. What that does is create jobs because people have to service that equipment now. We have to figure out what we're going to do with the data. There's a lot of jobs out there to figure out what to do with that data and how to analyze it.
If a job goes away, I think a new opportunity is created, like the cloud. The cloud is a whole new way, like all the subscriptions that everybody does, all that subscription-based business. While one opportunity may leave, or let's just say retail, you no longer need those stores as much as you used to because everybody can order online. But now you have a whole new industry of how do you manage that on the back end. You still have all that demand.
What CISCO can really do is help employees impacted by technology evolve their skill set to take advantage of the new jobs provided by technology.
Because our technologies are so innovative and we can help cut costs in certain ways, like in security or collaborative tools so that you don't have to travel or have so many conference rooms, then those companies have additional OPEX to expand and do research in other areas where they can invest.
I think it's enabling our customers to do better business. If you drive more business, you drive more customer demand. That demands more people to kind of care for the business.
It's really about evolving the capabilities of people. Like at McDonald's, you don't need the person to stand behind the counter necessarily and take your order when you can do it yourself at a kiosk. That person then may be able to be a manager at the store or do something else or work on the actual technology that they're deploying in the stores and take care of it and make sure that it's running properly.
So yes, the technologies that CISCO develops and sells are absolutely impacting the way jobs are created and done in the United States.
There's a lot of people that aren't connected to the internet that need access to better healthcare, better information, more educational stuff, those kinds of things. Here in the States, we have a lot of people connected to the internet, but there's still a lot of people that aren't. Connectivity out to the very rural communities is very difficult and expensive. So getting more people in the States online, that's kind of where I think our big contribution is to change the way people live, work, play, and learn.